morning, students. I'm Dr. Anita Pandey from Sri Shankaracharya Mahavidyalaya Jinwani, and today we are going to talk on topic strategy and its levels. So let's start. Let's look at the definition of strategy. What exactly is strategy? So strategy is a tactical course of action which is designed to achieve long-term objectives. It is an art and science of planning and marshalling resources for their most efficient and effective use in a changing environment. So let's look at this strategy as an activity that we undertake at planning level for anything in life, not just business, but also for suppose your exams or anything. You need a strategy, a lookout, a vision, how you are going to go through with things. So that is what helps you in planning your in designing your activities or thinking up your activities in such a way that you are able to achieve your long-term objectives. It is both an art and a science, because on one side it goes with some it has some principles, some universally acceptable principles, whereas it is also flexible and gives an individual their own level of flexibility as to how they plan their things. Of course, strategy is all about marshalling resources. You cannot undertake anything without making use of optimum without ensuring optimum utilization of resources. So for being efficient and effective, strategy is very important. Strategy of a business enterprise consists of what management decides about the future direction and scope of the business. See, every management, every business has a set of objectives and goals, whether long-term or short-term, which eventually lead to the wealth maximization of stakeholders and job enrichment and job satisfaction for employees and various other levels of achievement of objectives for various stakeholders that there are in a business. Now, it entails managerial choices amongst alternative action programs, competitive moves and different business environment. So we can say that strategy is a game plan of management. Now here, let us look at the definition of strategy as given by Gluck and Alfred D. Chandler. So, the definition of Gluck says, strategy is unified, comprehensive and integrated plan relating the strategic advantage of the firm to the challenges of the environment. Strategy is unified, comprehensive and integrated. Now, what do you mean by this? It means that strategy eventually, maybe every department has its own strategy for achievement of its objective, but at the end of the day, there is a goal congruence, that is achievement of organizational goals. If every department starts working according to them for achievement of only their objective, then there will be total disarray in the business. So that is why strategy should be unified and all comprehensive and totally integrated for an entire business organization for achievement of advantages. Now it is designed to ensure that the basic objective of the firms are achieved. Now the definition as given by Alfred D. Chandler is, the determination of basic long-term goals and objectives of an enterprise and adoption of the courses of action and allocation of resources necessary for carrying out these goals. Now, what does this mean? It means that goal determination or the task of setting goals for an organization is also a part of strategy, and it further leads to adoption of courses of action, planning and other procedures, and allocation of various resources, be it money, men, or a machine, or anything, towards achievement of those goals. So that is where our strategy is born. Now, let's look at features of strategy. Now, strategy is primarily top management's responsibility. Of course, for daily working and day-to-day routine, you have inputs from your lower level of management or supervisory level, but the overall strategy, the mission, vision, goals of an organization are always set by top management, and they are top management. That is why top management's responsibility is strategy formulation. Allocation of large amount of resources. Now, any strategy requires allocation of resources. Without them, you can't undertake your procedures or various steps for achievement, for fulfilling those strategies. Impact on long-term prosperity of the firm, future-oriented. Now, any strategy is future-oriented. It is based on forecasts and goals of the company. Impact on long-term prosperity. Of course, if your strategy fails, there is a chance that you will incur huge loss. If your strategy succeeds, then we have examples of various successful business houses like Reliance, Tata, etc. So what makes them successful? That is their strategy. Now, multifunctional or multi-business consequences. Now, strategy is a multifunctional and multi-business. It has multifunctional and multi-business consequences. It doesn't mean that if a strategy fails, it doesn't affect particularly one department or particular unit or section. It impacts a lot of functions of an organization and business. It has many business consequences. Consideration of factors in the external environment. Of course, you have to take into consideration external environment factors such as technology, government policies, changing legal scenarios, etc. for formulation of your strategy. Strategy is never stagnant. It is like an ever-flowing river. So it is a continuous process which businesses have to be very consistent with. Now let's look at levels of strategy. First is corporate strategy, which more or less entails the business you should be in. It is overall strategy of an organization, and it decides what direction you are heading to, right? Then comes business strategy, which is tactics to beat the competition. Now, once you have decided that yes, in this particular sector you'll function, then comes the worry regarding your competition. Of course, every business has to be very, very, very prudently conscious of competition that they are facing. Then the last is functional strategy, which is operational methods to implement the tactics. Now, functional strategy is something very basic, which is delegated down. So it delineates down to the basic levels, the middle level and lower management of an organization. Now, corporate level strategy. Let's understand everything in brief. Corporate level strategy. At this level, strategic decisions relate to organization-wide policies and are taken by top-level management with a vision of determining where the company wants to be. Now, corporate-level strategy, as I said, is overall strategy of an organization. It decides which direction you want to go to and what are your objectives in the long run. Then it has two main aspects, formulation of strategy and strategy implementation. In fact, any strategy has these two basic aspects. So formulation of strategy is very value-oriented, very goal-oriented, and is done by top-level management. And then strategy implementation, first it is communicated to the employees of an organization, the middle management, lower management, and then as a cohesive unit, the organization endeavors to implement those strategies. There is also a greater risk, cost, and profit potential as well, which is very true for any type of corporate, of any strategy. So, and of course, you need greater level of skills and flexibility is associated with this level, because you have to be very conscious that your corporate level strategy is going to affect the entire future, what your organization will be, maybe say 10 years down the line. So top management really has a very difficult task in determining corporate level strategy. Major financial policy decisions involving acquisition, diversification, or say demergers, amalgamations, etc. are taken at this level. Okay, now let's move on to business level strategy. Now, business level strategy is more likely related to a unit within the whole. It is concerned with competition in the market. The concerns are about what products or services should be developed and offered to which markets in order to meet customer needs and organizational objectives. Now, business level strategy is all about what products you are selling or what services you are selling, how your customers perceive you, what are the competition around you, or may be it from direct competition or indirect competition like from substitute products. So this business level strategy is actually multifunctional strategies developed at corporate level are then formulated and implemented. So first, overall corporate level strategy is formulated and implemented. Then for achievement of those objectives and those vision towards which then organization is working, business level strategy are formulated, and which includes decisions such as product development, marketing mix, research and development, personnel, etc. Now let's move on to functionalist level strategy. Now, functional and operational level strategy is more concerned with doing the right things or doing things right. You know, doing things right. Now, while corporate and business level strategies are concerned with doing the right things, those are the levels where your entire roadmap of the firm is formulated. After that, you come down to how to do things right so that you achieve those right things. Now, functional strategy involves decision making with respect to specific functional areas such as production, marketing, personal finance, etc. Operating level strategy is concerned with strategic approaches for managing frontline operating units and for handling day-to-day tasks of strategic significance. Of course, you can't go up to your top level management for these functional strategies. So what happens is, for these functional or operational level strategies, your lower level management or the employees at base level are involved. Thus, it makes it is an ideal practice to have contribution from employees also, so that they feel involved in an organization. And there is no the proverbial wall between the management and the employees. This functional level strategy, functional level strategic management, is the management of relatively narrow areas of activity which are of vital, pervasive, and containing importance to the total organization. Because at the end of the day, it is these functional or operational level strategies which help you achieve those business level strategy, and in turn which helps you achieve the corporate level strategy. So that's all for today. Thank you.